Welcome back to Front Row Reviews Horror Month 2010. Of course, we're doing all horror movies all this month. In celebration of Halloween, or just because we like horror movies. And I'm Vince Maniacci.
And I am David Gray.
We are reviewing the movie Let Me In,
which is based off of the original Swedish film. Unlike what I said during the trailer talk, I called it a French movie, but it wasn't a French movie. It's actually a Swedish film, and I wanted to correct that.
Well, see, I've never seen the whether it's Swedish or French, either way, I never saw the original, so...
But, you know, if I had never saw the Swedish movie, and I went and seen this, you know, I would have been probably even more blown away than what I was when I saw this. The first thing this movie had going for it, for me anyway, is it took place in the 1980s. And any movie that takes place in the 1980s, I almost automatically like, because that's basically when we grew up, was in the 80s.
Yeah, I like that fact too. And in this movie, they did it up really well. It wasn't quite stereotypical 80s, you know, where they put blatant 80s stuff in it. It was to a tad, but I mean, because they do have like Miss Pac-Man, and there's a whole scene with a Rubik's Cube. So,
and I was gonna say, I love the arcade thing. I mean, I can remember going into arcades like that, and that's why I can really identify with the 80s movies, because I was there. And it just, you know, that's what the arcades looked like in the 80s, and they were just awesome.
Even like the cars and the music, and yeah, the whole feel, the arcade, everything, it did feel like the 80s, so it was pretty cool.
First of all, I gotta say, this might sound weird, but I think this movie is too good of a film for the average horror audience.
Yeah, that sounds pretty weird.
Because it's a horror movie, but in reality, it's not really a horror movie. So all these people who are going to go see this expecting to see blood, guts, just, you know, and are used to seeing like the Saw movies and the Freddy movies and the Friday 13th movies are going to go in there probably expecting to see something like this, and it's not what it is. It's nothing like that whatsoever. So I think a lot of these horror fans are going to go in there expecting this just brutal killing movie, and you know, this has almost nothing to do with this whatsoever.
As much as I did enjoy the story in this, it was a really good story. It's very, the way it plays out, it's an awesome story. They did a great story here. But the only thing, my only big gripe about this film, or not even that big of a gripe, but my only gripe toward this film is that it is so slow. I mean, it's really slow paced. I mean, when it starts out, it almost gets to a point where you're bored with it, and then something really exciting does happen, and then again, it does that throughout the whole film.
Yeah, I was never, not one second in this movie, bored with it, ever. Not one frame, not one second, was I watching this movie that I was just not in it. I mean, I was so in this movie. I love the characters, I love the story. I never, never thought it was boring, ever.
Well, I understand that, Dave, but what I'm saying is...
Never.
It's not that, I didn't say that I get bored with it. I'm saying it gets you to that point where you could get bored with it.
I mean, the characters in this movie is what makes the movie. I mean, it's what really gets you in the film. That's what I just said, was it's too good for a horror fan. A horror fan's going to go to see it, and they're going to expect a horror movie, and that's not what this is. This is a drama. It's a drama with horror elements in it.
It wasn't scary, and that's what I'm getting at. When the surprise did come, you weren't all that surprised by it because it took so long to get to it.
No, I completely and totally, absolutely, 100% disagree with you.
I liked the movie, actually. I thought it was actually a really well done film. I thought the direction was really good. I thought the I thought it had a lot of great thing aspects to it. I thought it was put together well, except for the slow pace. But, and the acting was superb.
The acting also, yeah, she was unbelievable. She was just amazing.
What happened there? Some kids from school? Where do you go to school anyway? I never see you.
Go and listen.
What? You have to hit back. You have to hit back hard.
I can't. There's three of them.
Then you hit back even harder.
It was creepy, and some parts are rather disgusting, but... or disturbing, not so much disgusting, but disturbing. So I wouldn't take any little kids to this, by the way.
It's not supposed to be a scary movie. Like I said, it's a drama with horror elements in it. It's not supposed to be scary.
But people are going to go there expecting this to be a horror film.
That's what I'm trying to say. It's not a horror movie. It's too good of a movie for the average horror fan. The horror fan are going to go see this and come out of it and expect, like what you're saying, oh, that was slow, man. There was no action in that movie. That's not what this is.
Relax now. Relax.
It's not that kind of movie.
Calm down, Dave.
You need to go see it again. That's what you need to do.
So her jumping up on top of the guy and ripping open his neck and tossing him around and all that, that's not supposed to happen in here because it's a drama.
I'm going to tell you right now, this is the best vampire movie I have ever seen.
Well, I can't say that. I can't say it's the best one I've ever seen.
This is the reason why I love movies. I mean, because you see something, and we haven't even mentioned this in the review, is this movie is so original. There's nothing like it except for the Swedish film.
This is definitely a different take and a new take on that type of story.
So you're saying it's a slow-moving horror film, and you had no idea, what it was about.
I'm just saying the way the movie plays out is that it's so slow you can predict what's going to happen. That was my only complaint about the movie. Other than that, I really enjoyed this film.
So what was name one thing in the movie that was predictable, like you knew what was going to happen? I want to hear it.
Like, I knew the cop was going to show up, and I knew the cop was going to go...
You know, obviously, if the guy's investigating the murder, he's a good investigator, he's going to go to the house to investigate it. I mean, it's obvious. Yeah, that's going to happen, because that's what he's doing through the whole movie.
When the actual, what's supposed to be a horrifying surprise happens, you already know it's going to happen, because... It's obvious.
It's called being the detective. That's what he's doing. He's putting everything together. So obviously, he's going to go to the person's place to find her. I mean, yeah, that's what's going to happen.
We're going to be doing this until November.
But that's not predictable because that's part of the movie. You knew he was going to do that.
I'm talking about the stuff that's supposed to be, the scares, the actual parts that are supposed to be scary.
I think you actually need to go re-see this movie. And then give it another review for it.
This is going to take us till December.
I can't wait to see it again. I would have go in a second to go see this movie again.
What would I give it?
What are you going to give it?
I would give this non-terrifying, drama-filled horror film. I would give it 4 Normans.
What you're going to get is the best horror movie of the year and possibly one of the best vampire films ever made. And I'm giving this our very first Golden Machete.
We're already heading into January. No, I don't find Driving Miss Daisy scary.
Make sure you got a round in the chamber and you're safely up.
I love the dead.
they're cool. The bluing flesh for me to hold. Cadaver eyes upon me see.
Know about the dead people, right?
Nothing.
You watch your ass.
Said they were working out how to solve this thing.
Broadcast stopped.
And that was the last we heard.